He's met and influenced many world leaders, and now he's about to tell you how to unite the America he loves.
That job's filled.
Unique.
Unique.
Brilliant.
Brilliant.
And unpredictable.
Unpredictable.
Robert Davi is a Renaissance man who writes, directs, sings, and does it all with excellence.
Yeah, it's okay. We're all very impressed, but let's get on with it now.
Robert Davi believes he should use his voice to both repay and help unite America, the America that made his dreams come true.
No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is The Robert Davi Show.
I wonder what the issue was. Sorry for technical difficulties. I've been away for the past over a week. I have been not doing it from in studio. So there's a little bit of technical difficulty we're fixing. Are we okay, Jeremy? All right. So Jeremy's got it under control. And so forgive us for the misstep. We had a huge misstep just now, and that happens. It happens on Fox News sometimes, right? Or CNN. And so we got a little false start. Hope you didn't turn the dial. Anyway, let me just tell you this. I was in Hilton Head, South Carolina for over a week. We broadcast from there. Went through this tropical storm that was 90-mile-an-hour winds. It was like getting hit from the tail of a huge alligator. It whipped around. It was interesting because in California here, we don't have rain, but it rained about 5 inches. But the topography of South Carolina is so beautiful. I'd been there before, but I'd not been to Hilton Head Island. And it, of course, the humidity has an effect, but a positive effect. The humidity is, but you feel like you're being bathed in a steam room part of the time. And then it cools down, but it was wonderful. The prices are very low there, unlike California. You could fill up your car. We had an SUV. My cousin lent me his SUV. My cousin lives there, beautiful home. He's very successful. And I filled up the tank for, I think it was $52. In Los Angeles, it would be $107. So gas was half the price there, as was other items. So the cost of living is down. The taxes are lower in some ways. And it's interesting when we see the beauty of this country. You know, when you get out of the pockets that you're living in and you see the gorgeous, that can we have a, here's where we have to be sensitive to the music. That pounding music, I much rather a more relaxed music. Nikki, my son is on the board. Yeah, Nick. Something more reflective. That other thing, I don't know what that is. We've got to really, and not just you, but I want everybody to listen to the beds. because I was re-listening to the show, and I don't know if it was annoying to you, but it was annoying to me. When I was just talking to you, just, you know, and not everything is a pound. Not everything has to be a pound. It can be a nice boat ride. It doesn't have to be choppy. And it was counterpointing my discussion that I had the other day. I listened to Friday's show, I believe. And it was very, very, very... some parts were great when I did the poem. That fell into place. But the other was a pounding kind of... And it was counterpointing exactly what I was saying. It didn't... It would be like doing rock and roll and you're singing an American standard, an American classic. So we've got to get more piano music. We have to look at different beds. Nick, make a reminder that we listen to some music today that we can use. You know, more varied. Some piano, Eric Satie. I like some of those piano symphonies he did. Anyway, this seems like a spiritual thing. I feel like I'm floating to the heavens. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That seemed, didn't it? You could go on, Nick. Come on. Nick was with me in Hilton Head. He had a blast. He met his cousins, really, for the first time. And was a great experience with the family. And that's what it's about, isn't it? It's about being able to spend time with people you love. And at the same time, experience and get a different viewpoint. This is the Salty Dog. I found out about the Salty Dog. I went to one when we did the Bond film years ago. Salty Dog was in, I remember, what's his name? Don Stroud, who played Heller in License to Kill. He would go there every night and he would be dancing and singing and having a ball and drinking. And I found out that the Salty Dog happened off of Hilton Head, and there's a whole myth about it. About a dog. There was a big storm and there was a wreck, and the crew was in the ocean, and the dog led them to safety, this Salty Dog, so the myth goes. And then they created this whole business around it, t-shirts, hats, restaurants, cafes, the Salty Dog. So I Salty Dogged up a little bit, got a couple of hats. Anyway, t-shirt, I didn't like how it fit on me. I've got to lose about 25 pounds before I put that t-shirt on, because it's one of those things that muscle tight, and if you got a little extra excess baggage, it doesn't quite go with you, you know. And of course, I always say I'm going to go on there and I'm going to eat light, and then of course you start eating, and there was some good seafood restaurants, and actually a good place that had pizza. I always look for a pizzeria when I'm in a different area, and I found a good place, a couple of them actually, good Italian. But what's on my mind? Now, things are happening around the world. Did you know that Cuba, they're marching in the streets in Cuba? There's a kind of a people's movement in Cuba, and they're shouting, carrying the American flag. They're holding the American flag among their own, and they're shouting Libertad, Libertad, liberty, freedom. How profound is that? And the same thing is happening to a certain extent in Haiti. You know, the president of Haiti was assassinated, and yet the people now are demanding, they're demanding to know what happened, the involvement that goes back to 2000 in Haiti, and also the rumored displace of money that the Clinton Foundation did when Haiti had its trouble. Where's all those millions of dollars that poured into Haiti? Where'd they go? They want answers. So it's interesting that Cuba, my dear friends, 90 miles off the coast of Florida, which has been a communist country for how many years? Cuba's been under socialistic Marxist regime for how many years? And they are floating the American flag and they're looking for Libertad. While here in America, there's an attack by the left, a continued attack, and I've talked about this for years. Go on Breitbart, look at some of my articles. Now, I know that Mark Levin, they call him the great one, has a new book called American Marxism, and it sounds interesting, but I've beat this drum for decades. I've beat the Marxist drum for decades, as had David Horowitz. And what's happening right now across America? I promised you a website or a name to write down. And I have it. I'll tell you in the next segment what it is that I'm going to build, because I want parents across America united for education. I want the parents, you, the moms and dads out there. It's so important. I want to create a movement with parents across this country that have children that are newborn, that are in college, to college. I need your help. I need your support. I need you to join me. Parents United for Education. We must pull together every part of us in society today. I don't care if you're Hispanic, you're black, you're Asian. We've got to unite. All parents must unite for education. Because the indoctrination that's been going on for decades, it's what created this swell for Bernie Sanders. It's this kind of, and most people say education, we haven't been educated, we've been indoctrinated. A purposeful, subversive indoctrination. And it's been slowly done since communists infiltrated our government, our unions, the educational system, the entertainment industry, and media throughout the 30s to 50s. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to ask you a question. Did you know withdrawing your cash from the bank can be very risky? That's right. So please listen up. Are you aware that banks are now required to spy on us for the government and then report any behavior they think is suspicious? It's true. I was shocked as I read Swiss America's blockbuster report, The Secret War on Cash. This new war against cash is really a war against all freedom-loving Americans. Listen to me. You must read The Secret War on Cash. Now get your free copy by calling 866-219-3750. That's 866-219-3750. Or visit SwissAmerica.com. This war on cash is growing daily and also includes all forms of digital money. So please, get ahead, read The Secret War on Cash free to every Robert Davi fan today by calling 866-219-3750. That's 866-219-3750. And then you'll thank me later.
Now it's time for Medved's Entertainment Minute.
A lavish new installment in the Avengers saga tries to give you the backstory of Natasha Romanoff, played by Scarlett Johansson, but better known as Black Widow, now playing in theaters and streaming on Disney+.
You don't know everything about me. I've lived a lot of lives before I was an Avenger, before I got this family. I made mistakes choosing between what the world wants you to be and who you are.
The film is full of that sort of philosophical dialogue, and it begins well, with a gripping scene of what seems like a normal American family suddenly in desperate danger. But the plotline will be difficult to follow for those not deeply schooled in the Avengers mythology, and the endless explosions, bursts of fire, and leaps through midair are more tedious than terrific. Supporting characters played by David Harbour, Rachel Weisz, and Ray Winstone are the best part of the movie. 2 stars for the incoherently indulgent Black Widow.
This review brought to you by the Thank Heaven Foundation.
If Ernest Hemingway was alive today, would he say this to you?
Shakespeare, Mark Twain, Edgar Allan Poe, all great writers. And after reading your book, I simply must add you to the list.
Wait, you don't have a book yet. So make a free call to Page Publishing. Their expert staff can help you turn your book idea into a real book, a masterpiece that could someday make the bestseller list in hard copy and digitally all across the world. Page Publishing can help you completely take your idea for a book, write it, and publish it. So if you want to join the ranks of some of the most famous authors in the world, call now for a free information kit. Turn your book idea into publishing gold. Make a free call right now to Page Publishing.
800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. That's 800-378-3212.
Robert Davi.
You know, I'm the one delivering the message, not receiving it.
Hey,
So as we were talking about a second ago, before the break, the indoctrination that the left, the Communist Party, has since the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, and the movement to infiltrate America. And I've talked about this. I've written about this on Breitbart, 2015, 2014, 2013, 2012. I've set those warning flares up every so often over the last couple of decades. I beg people to listen. But you know what happens is I get on those talk shows. I've been on Fox for so often, many times on Fox, on different shows, and they want to talk to me about Hollywood, more about how does Hollywood think about this and Hollywood think about that. And just because I'm an actor, they think that my lane is Hollywood, when it's much more wider than Hollywood. It encompasses that. Don't forget, I've traveled the world for decades, playing all different kinds of characters and researching them fully, researching what's happening in this nation. When I was a kid, at 6 and 7 and 8 and 9 and 10 and 12, me and my cousins, who one cousin got a PhD in the science of political theory. Another cousin has multiple degrees in business, all successful. One is the top lawyer. That's right, the top lawyer at Penn State. He's the Wharton School, the law school. He's the head of the law school. So we had very intelligent conversations growing up. We weren't just entertaining Italians, doing the tarantella. And what they look at me, they see me, and they think of me as just an actor, not just somebody. Now, I don't have a degree. I don't have a law degree. I don't have that. I focused on entertainment, culture. That was my lane, so to speak. And I've written so much about this. And the movement, the insidious movement that the communists, the Marxists, as Mark Levin calls American Marxism. Well, I've called that for years, okay? And it's been incrementally injected into education and culture. And this is why we have a nation today where a radical socialist like Bernie Sanders, who's a Marxist, was a serious candidate for president. And why AOC and Rashid Tlaib, Marxists have infiltrated. And John Brennan himself was a Marxist, was a communist. And then he changed, of course, and they want to whitewash it. We've got to say that Marxism is here in our nation. The people like Marcuse and Dewey, who created education in America, were Marxists. These are the guys that created education in America. We're being led like sheep, and our people have been lobotomized, not woken. They call it the woke. Do you see how the right gets, the left captures the imagination of linguistics? So they call it woke. You're woke. Bernie Sanders, when he was on a talk show several years ago, was demonizing businesses and preaching the need for wealth redistribution. And the host didn't challenge it at all. The great giveaway in the least, not a word, not the slightest challenge to his ideas, just silent compliance. Why? Why was there just science? And why do we see this continually over and over again? I see these talk show hosts nod their heads on CNN and MSNBC saying the most outrageous things, and even on Fox News and other networks. They're not challenging these people, these politicians. I was watching a show yesterday, I think it was on Fox, and who was it? It was Trey Gowdy, yeah, from South Carolina. He was asking another politician a question. That guy, and he pivoted. The guy never answered his question. I wanted to see what his answer would be like. But they don't hold him accountable. Because what happens? Their handlers and other people. It's just like in Hollywood. You can't ask. This is off limits. Well, this politician pivoted. And I wish Trey Gowdy had stayed on point. You have to stay on point. We have to hold this accountable. We have to have communication, honest communication. Now, If Bernie Sanders wants to start with redistribution of wealth, why doesn't he challenge Hollywood in its wealth redistribution? Corporate greed hoards wealth from the rest of us. Well, the entertainment industry is full of corporations, movie stars, musicians, celeb producers, directors at the top. Now, why don't the stars who command $20 million for a film give away, say, $5 million from their salaries and redistribute among the other cast and crew? And this kind of hypocrisy goes on throughout the entertainment industry. There's more greed, waste, clueless, irrational, out-of-touch behavior in Hollywood than anywhere else. Modern-day commissars on the front lines, leading the nation toward ruin in a certain way. The bleeding heart liberal has been replaced with the pervasive progressive. And look, I'm all for progressive ideas. We need them. You see, I've told the right so many times, we've got to deal with climate, environment. We've got to get on board with all of that. But what we have to do is use common sense solutions. And it's my criticism of the right, the continued bashing of things. It's like this week, CPAC, why would they boo Caitlyn Jenner? Forget your religious affiliations and your beliefs. It's another human being. She's a human being that went through a transformation for herself. Why judge her? Are you the judge? I'm not the judge. Let God be the judge. Let's stop the judgment. So what you do is you alienate and you look like yahoos. We can't be that. We have to be open. We have to be acceptable. We have to be, you don't have to vote for her, but you don't have to denigrate anyone. We have to stop the denigration. It starts with us. Just as the left denigrates conservatives. Then we have the moral ground to go against them, to say to them, stop what you're doing to conservatives. I'm glad Donald Trump is going after big media. Because that's a danger. No ideas out there. Many books have been written about all of this. And I think a book that everyone should write, because, you know, it's again, or everyone should read, it's like John the Baptist crying out in the wilderness. If no one's listening, what do you do? What do you do? Let's say, there was a book several years ago called 50 Shades of Grey. This book, 50 Shades of Grey. Did you read it? Many people read it. But let's just say a book like Mark Levin's American Marxism, or David Horowitz's The Art of Political War, or Mike Savage's Government Zero. This is a book that should be read. These are books you have to read. You need to be informed, educated. American, we have to wake up. Parents united for education. Parents united for education. Parents united for education. This is Robert Davi. Allow me to introduce you to the most trusted name in precious metals, Swiss America. Since 1982, they've been helping Americans protect their wealth from dangerous government spending and runaway debt. Now, it's no secret gold and silver prices have rocketed over the last decade. With all of the rising uncertainty, experts say precious metal prices are headed much higher in the months and years ahead. Now, to help protect my fans, Swiss America has a very special offer. Swiss Walking Liberty half dollars at the amazingly low price of $12.50 each delivered. That's right, $12.50. So call now, reserve your silver coins at 866-219-3750. That's 866-219-3750. 3750. Silver Walking Liberty half dollars from Swiss America. For just $12.50 each delivered while supplies last. Again, 866-219-3750. 866-219-3750. Do it today.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet, fresh asparagus, hollandaise on the side, a filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flare, close your eyes, and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Roots Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef. Broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at rootschris.com or by calling 800-544-0808. Tired of lockdown? Let the reconnect begin. You belong here. Welcome home to the magic of Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante in Fullerton, California. Check out our new spacious outdoor dining al fresco. Romantic, market lights. It looks like a movie set. Dine under the stars and enjoy our tasty Angelo's and Vinci's pizza, pasta, seafood, chicken, salad dinners, and more. In the cool of the evening, come enjoy our award-winning menu, new wine list, specialty cocktails, like our Peach Bellini Martini, appetizers, and more. Angelo's and Vinci's now open every day from 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. for relaxing outdoor dining. No reservations needed. Just come on in for delicious Italian food. Angelo's and Vinci's Restaurante, 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton. Call 714-879-4022. We're going to need a lot of pasta to get through this year. Come to Angelo's and Vinci's at 550 North Harbor Boulevard in Fullerton today.
Trying to sell your old car? Instead, donate your vehicle to Heritage for the Blind. Pickup is free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats, whether they run or not. Call right now and receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to over 50 locations. Call 1-800-785-9618. Donate your car today. That's 1-800-785-9618.
All right, is that a Q2 or a Q3 expense?
Dwayne's CPA went MIA.
W9.
To keep his books and his sanity, he needs to find a replacement ASAP.
Hey, Johnny, have you ever heard of a fungible good?
Indeed can help him hire the people he needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
The Robert Davi Show.
I'm Dwayne Robinson, LAPD. I'm in charge here.
Not anymore.
So I can't tell you, my dear friends, how important it is, Parents United for Education. Now, I'm going to give you more information on that tomorrow. I want us to band across America. I want every single parent that has a child that wants education in America to go forward in an unindoctrinated way. Let's teach history. Let's teach the truth. Let's not teach critical race theory. Let's be sensitive to each other. Let's start anew. What Donald Trump, what Reagan said at the end of his term, his two terms, Ronald Reagan said, an informed American patriotism is what's needed for the nation to survive. This is what we need. And I wrote an article the week Trump won office asking him to please pick up that mantle. And it wasn't done. Now, Ron DeSantis recently talked about that in Florida. We have to do this. And I wrote an article called Red, White, and Blue, Teaching Our Children Red, White, and Blue. And this was in 2010. Here's what I'm saying about being able to understand the times. Now, there was a name change several years ago that went unnoticed by most of you. I'm sure most don't know it. But given the light that Cuba today is marching in the streets with the American flag, that we're having that in Haiti, in Hong Kong, and they're using the American flag as a symbol for freedom, holding it up high, while in America, they're throwing it on the ground. They're throwing it on the ground. They're disrespecting our flag. And do you know there's a man in the Civil War, William Harvey Carney? I'm going to talk about him in the last segment. I want you to remember that name. There should be a stamp for this gentleman. A black man. William Harvey Carney. Now, Mount Denali. President Obama decides to rename Alaska's Mount McKinley, the highest peak in North America, to Denali, to comply with what Alaskans supposedly have wanted and been calling the mountain for years. Now, I understand, but you see what Obama did, really, was test the waters, I believe. He just spit in the face of the GOP and the legacy of President McKinley, who was a Republican president. McKinley was a Republican president. Now, I don't want to give you a history lesson, but let's talk about William McKinley's accomplishments. Do you know that he fought for the Union in the Civil War? McKinley did. His family were abolitionists. McKinley's family were abolitionists who wanted to end slavery long before Lincoln issued the Emancipation Proclamation. And he ran for office at a very difficult time when the Democrat president had damaged the country and the United States was spinning into a depression. Enter McKinley, a Republican who believed in the gold standard, approved tariffs to help manufacturers and workers in America. Sound familiar? And turn the economy around. He also helped liberate Cuba from Spain. What's happening today in Cuba? They're in the streets shouting Libertad with the American flag. It's interesting. McKinley was a popular president who served our nation well. But his time in office was cut short by an assassin's bullet. He was shot dead early in his second term by a left-wing anarchist. Another interesting fact, don't you think? And in 2015... President Obama decides to take his name off of Mount McKinley. And so the Alaskans can have their Mount Denali back. Even though they refer to it as that. Now, McKinley's towering achievements. Alaskans began to refer to Denali as Mount McKinley back in the day. And this became official in 1917. Until it was stripped away by Barack Obama in 2015. Now, this probably to you out there seems insignificant scheme of things. But let's take a much deeper look at what this act represented. My dear fellow Americans, symbols mean something. And while we're all sensitive to the multiculturalism in our nation, it's e pluribus unum. We're sensitive to indigenous people, of course. And their population. But do you think that this name change was solely done for the Alaskans' benefit? Every Alaskan, including the Alaskan natives, had been using the name Denali interchangeably with Mount McKinley for years. After all, the area the mountain is located is called the Denali National Park. Now, have you heard any of the politicians or pundits, any of them, give me one in 2015 that talked about this. I wrote about it. That really framed the significance of this name change. None of them did it. So far, all we've really heard is the localized outrage of politicians from President McKinley's home state in Ohio. As if this were merely a slight to Ohio and not the entire nation that President McKinley served. And even that perceived insult to Ohio was treated as largely insignificant to a modern public that has forgotten so much of its past. And look what they're doing to our past now. It's coming down. They're taking it away. This is what the Marxists said. You understand? Marx said, get rid of the past so we can create what we want anew. That's what's happening here. Wake up. Parents united for education. Wake up. I beg you to wake up. While you may think this name change amounts to a hill of beans in this difficult world, it was more than that. And I said this in 2015. It's another attempt by modern left-wing progressives to incrementally dismantle our history and our culture. What if in 100 years some future president decided to strip away the legacy and civic honors bestowed on heroic Americans like Martin Luther King Jr. or on presidents like John F. Kennedy and Abraham Lincoln, both of whom were assassinated in office, like McKinley? Do you think there would be outrage over that? Or would it seem as innocuous as this current act of historical erasure? See, that's what happened. That was a test. Because you know what? They're talking about taking down Abraham Lincoln, aren't they? They're talking about taking historical figures that people that have reminded us of our past, like the Taliban. They want to destroy the past. It is a danger, parents. United for Education, wake up, please. Join me. We need to join our hands. You know there's a death grip. If I had another hand, it goes something like this. There's a grip. When someone is in danger, you grip them like this, and we need this grip across America. We need this grip across America. No longer can we be splintered in our little compartmentalized. We don't need, what do they call them, franchisees. That's what I call all the pundits. We're all franchisees. I've got this franchise, you've got that franchise. We all separate each other. Instead of joining together, we need to join together. Do you understand? Us. The U.S. Us. We must join together. Symbols mean something. History means something. And honors bestowed must be respected and kept. McKinley, my fellow Americans, was initially given the honor by Alaskans during the time of their gold rush because he favored the gold standard. In fact, his position on gold might have been why he was assassinated. Now, how's that for a surreal turnabout? On a very side note, I wish some of the smug guests on different shows showed a little more balance on their comments on this issue. So, in the spirit of my old friend, you know Peter Falk did Columbo. One more thing on this issue. And, well, could it be? I'm going to save it for the next segment. Robert Davi, back in a moment, please. We'll wrap up Mount Denali. William Harvey.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you could donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-785-9618. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you for calling, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to many exciting locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now, 1-800-785-9618. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher. Call now, 1-800-785-9618. That's 1-800-785-9618.
When you really want Italian food, you have got to get to Columbo's. Columbo's Italian Steakhouse and Jazz Club, Colorado Boulevard, Eagle Rock. It's that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Citizens, no need now to clamor for culinary gustatorial delights. Dreams do come true. Columbo's has triumphantly reopened its golden doors to feed the famished and soothe the savage beast. Bask in the delights of Columbo's succulent steaks, Neptune's superior offerings from the seven seas, Columbo's family Italian specialties, and, of course, their world-famous meatballs. And it's all so affordable. Yes, Columbo's, the ninth wonder of the world, the Southern California pantheon dedicated to unrivaled and unparalleled yum-yum. Columbo's, that little neighborhood place you wish was down the street from you. Columbo's, mangia bene.
Now it's time for MedVed's Entertainment Minute.
Director Steven Soderbergh assembles a great ensemble cast for a moody thriller about petty crooks in 1954 Detroit who get drawn into a series of world-changing mysteries in No Sudden Move. Now playing in theaters and streaming on HBO Max.
The problem is you're not smart enough to know how not smart you are.
Why are you doing this, man?
Because I'm gonna get what's mine.
That's Don Cheadle, who along with Benicio Del Toro is at the center of the action, along with the likes of Ray Liotta, Matt Damon, and John Hamm. The plot, which features some conspiratorial maneuvers in the auto industry, is intricate and intriguing. But the real power of this picture comes from the characterizations, which are consistently convincing and complex. It's rated R for rough language, some sex references, and disturbing violence that's plausible, but never over the top. 3 stars for No Sudden Move, a supremely skillful piece of work that leaves you wondering about the deeper dimensions of what you've just seen.
Robert Davi.
Another $80 million write-off.
I guess it's time to start cutting overhead.
So, getting back to Mount Denali, to wrap it up, that Obama renamed Mount McKinley. Now, the Alaskans rewarded Mount McKinley, because he helped during the gold rush. He helped that nation. He helped that state. And when you take it down, the name, and I told you he was an abolitionist. His family were, before the emancipation, before Lincoln, assassinated during his second term. The accomplishments of McKinley, a GOP Republican president. And I mentioned that, what if in 100 years they took down JFK or Martin Luther King? Well, guess what? Aren't they talking about it now? They're talking about that less than 5 years. 6 years of that article that I wrote. The danger of Mount McKinley, that no one talked about. No one discussed except for a few seconds. But that was a trial run. Don't you understand? This was a trial run. If they let McKinley, who was against slavery, who fought in the Civil War on the Union side, if they took him down, the highest peak in North America, they could take anything down. And that's what they're doing now. They're talking about getting rid of the Statue of Liberty. They took down Teddy Roosevelt, Lewis and Clark. General Lee, I understand Confederacy. But history is history. History is history. And we should be able to, how much more interesting? It'd be like saying, you know what, let's take, you go to Disneyland and you say, you know what, I don't like Minnie and I don't like Donald Duck. And I don't like, and you start taking down, it never stops. The Marxists will never stop until you're in a Maoist uniform. Wake up, Parents United for Education. And I call it that because I wanted something positive to grab onto. And more about that tomorrow. I want to talk about, pivot right now on another symbol. I think he should have a national stamp. I don't believe he does. A man named William Harvey Carney. Have you ever heard of him? Now, if they're talking about critical race theory, how come in the decades of education that I've gone through and that my children have gone through, none of them can tell me about this gentleman? William Harvey Carney, born February 29th, 1840. He died December 9th, 1908. He was an American soldier during the Civil War, born as a slave. Yes, he was a slave. He was awarded the Medal of Honor in 1900 for his gallantry in saving the regimental colors, the American flag. A black man who was a slave, who raised the American flag and wouldn't let it touch the ground during the Battle of Fort Wagner in 1863. The action for which he received the Medal of Honor preceded that of any other African-American Medal of Honor recipient. However, his medal was actually the last to be awarded for the Civil War service. Now, African Americans received the Medal of Honor as early as April 1865. Now, who was this slave? Who was William Harvey Carney? He was born as a slave in Norfolk, Virginia, February 29th, 1840, made his way to freedom. We don't know how. But according to most accounts, he escaped through the Underground Railroad and joined his father in Massachusetts. And other members of their family were freed by purchase or by the death of their master. Carney joined the 54th Massachusetts Volunteer Infantry in March of 1863 and was later promoted to sergeant due to his heroism and actions during the Battle of Fort Wagner. He took part in the July 18th, 1863 assault on Fort Wagner in Charleston, South Carolina, where I just was. His actions there earned him the Medal of Honor. When the color guard was killed, what did Carney do? He retrieved the U.S. flag. He marched forward with it despite serious wounds. And when the Union troops were forced to retreat under fire, he struggled back across the battlefield, eventually returning to his own lines and turning over the colors to another survivor of the 54th, saying, "Boys, I only did my duty. The old flag never touched the ground. Boys, I did my duty. The old flag never touched the ground." He received an honorable discharge in June 1864. He then went back to Massachusetts, took a job maintaining the city's streetlights, and delivered mail for 32 years. He was a founding vice president of the New Bedford branch, 18, of the National Association of Letter Carriers in 1890. He married Susanna Williams, and they had a daughter, Clara Heronia. He spent a few years in California, then returned again in 1869. He received the Medal of Honor on May 23rd, 1900, 37 years after the events of Fort Wagner. More than half of such awards from the Civil War were presented 20 or more years earlier after the fact. 20 African-American men received the medal before him. But because his actions happened earlier than the others, some have incorrectly cited him as the first to receive the medal. His citation reads, "When the color sergeant was shot down, the soldier grasped the flag, led his way to the parapet, and planted the colors thereon. When the troops fell back, he brought the flag under a fierce fire, in which he was twice severely wounded." Boys, the old flag never touched the ground. He died in a Boston City hospital, December 9th, 1908, from an elevator accident. William Harvey Carney, a slave who fought in the Civil War with the Union, who saved the flag from touching the ground. Boys, the old flag never touched the ground. And today they spit on it. They turn their backs on it because of the Marxist infiltration in our nation. Are you gonna let that happen? This is the history that should be brought out. Men like this, black men like this, should be on the lips of every single American. Over 300 million Americans should shout this man's name in the face of Antifa, in the face of Black Lives Matter, in the face of Obama. And how about this? How about being proud of this man, Michelle? I've never heard you talk about him. Why? Why is this man not held up high? Where's his stamp? Where's his statue? He might have one. I believe he does have one. I believe he has a statue. I think I read he has a statue. His statue is prominently featured in his hometown of West Point Cemetery in Norfolk, Virginia, atop a monument to African-American Civil War and Spanish-American War veterans. They topple everything in this Marxist society that we're in. I disdain them. I disdain them. I don't want... They shouldn't... We have to unite against this. The indoctrination I've seen in decades happening to our country. We need a force of nature to bring this up every single day. This is the informed American patriotism that needs to be taught in school. These stories need to be told. And others. Others on the other side of the equation. Let's tell the stories. But let's not denigrate our nation. Let's celebrate the stories of our nation, of our differences, of our uniqueness. This is what we have to do as Americans. This is what we were meant to do. We were not meant to separate. The smugness of Kamala Harris, the whispery of Joe Biden, the out-of-touch left-wing Nancy Pelosi and Schumer and Schiff and O'Connell and the rest of them that keep us separated. We've got to get rid of the politicians that are around today. We need term limits. We need accountability. And we need education. We need to recapture culture. This is what we need. You've given up, haven't you? Some. You know, some people are so busy making their lives that they don't get involved. And before you know it, a country topples. How many years has Cuba been under socialism, Marxism, communism? And the people have had enough. It doesn't work. It does not work. Yes, we need fairer playing fields, fairer this, fairer that. I wish I had more this, a more opportunity here. And you can go on and on about it. But what we have uniqueness is our common goal of this nation. The United States of America, the flag. And those athletes that turn their backs on it. My dear fellow Americans, I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Parents United for Education. God bless you.
Are you tired of your favorite talk show sounding like this? What if you can hear your favorite talk shows in crystal clear, high definition sound? Well, with CRN Digital Talk Radio, 7 channels of high definition radio, you can now hear all your favorite hosts like you've never heard them before. In true